Our Pledge of Allegiance. And it is my pleasure to introduce our amazing chamber choir, and they will be leading us in our national anthem. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may have a seat. Okay. All right. It is my greatest pleasure to introduce my best friend since the seventh grade and also our class president, Miss Taylor Case.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Taylor Case, and I am honored to be speaking on behalf of the class of 2021 as the senior class president. Thank you for joining us as we celebrate the success and strength of our seniors. The disappointments we faced this year were unprecedented. No one expected to spend most of senior year sitting in their bedrooms, interacting with their close peers through a computer screen, and being shielded from normalcy behind masks and dividers. However, instead of focusing on past regrets and what we may have missed, we must focus on how lucky we are to be gathered here today as an entire class to recognize our persistence and to celebrate our achievements. As a class, we have come together to learn many things. We have learned to value every stage life has to offer because you never truly know what the future has in store. We have learned to make the most of a situation that many would deem as hopeless by maintaining normalcy with what we were given. Most of all, we learned to appreciate school a little extra than we usually do. Up until this year, it would be nearly impossible to imagine not spending our final time as Huntington Blue Devils, walking the halls with our best friends, spreading free periods hanging out with our favorite teachers, and gathering at the best locker hangout spots. COVID has taught us to value our relationships with our peers and staff members, to enjoy each day we get to spend in a classroom environment, and to soak up every aspect of the quintessential high school experience, both the good and the bad, because you never know what an amazing experience you've been offered until it's gone. On behalf of our senior class, I would like to give a huge thank you to Ms. Jordan Schessler and Ms. Amelia Sajace, who was not able to attend today. These two teachers worked tirelessly as our class advisors throughout the years, and I, as well as many others, have been fortunate enough to receive their guidance in navigating through high school, inspiring school spirit, and representing our grade with pride. Although a large portion of our funds raised over the past 4 years were put directly into planning our amazing prom for our seniors, the class of 2021 still wanted to use the remaining money to give back to the hardworking classes below us. Speaking on behalf of many students who have been part of fundraising, we know the struggles of coming up with clever and fun ways to raise money, especially during a pandemic. Therefore, the remains of our funds will be gifted back to the rising junior and senior classes to help offset the cost of their banquet and prom. Once again, I would like to give a huge thank you to Huntington High School for bringing us together, creating lifelong friendships, and providing a place we can call home for years to come. I wish the best of luck to everyone with all the exciting new places life takes them, but always remember, there's no place like home. Thank you.
Thank you, Tay. Couldn't think of anybody better to represent our class. Normally at this point in the program, I'd be introducing our salutatorian, but as we all know, nothing about this year is normal. So this year we have two valedictorians with identical averages of 104.46. Yeah, 104.46. Yeah, it's crazy. So I first would like to welcome Gabriel Moskovich, who will be presenting one of our valedictorians.
When Grace moved in next door, I was 10 months old. My parents invited her family over for dinner, and even though Grace was only 6 months older, she was so much better behaved than me. Over the years, my memories of Grace have been mixed. Of course, they're all great, but they range from Grace screaming like she was being murdered when her brother or I would beat her at basketball, to her absolutely destroying me in most board games. She has since grown out of the screaming, for the most part anyway, but she's obviously gotten smarter and better as a friend. She's kind and generous and my best friend. I hope you continue to grow, and I can't wait to watch from the sidelines. Your valedictorian, Grace Wildermuth.
Thank you, Gabe. That was so sweet. Right now, I'm going to call up Alex to help me say thank you to everyone who's made this year possible.
Is that good?
On behalf of the class of 2021, we thank Ms. Bernacki and the Board of Education, our district superintendent, Mr. Polanski, and our assistant superintendents, Dr. Acker and Ms. McCoy.
We'd also like to thank our principal, Mr. Cusack, our assistant principals, Dr. Lors and Mr. Smith, our deans, Mr. Kaleka, Mr. Gilmore, and Mr. Wilson, and our faculty and staff.
We extend a special thank you this year to our school nurse, Ms. Amaranti, who's kept us healthy, and our custodians and groundspeople who have kept us safe and clean. We appreciate your extra effort.
We would also like to thank our class advisors who have put in so much work towards making our senior year special. Thank you to Ms. Schessler.
And Mrs. Sajace, who cannot be here today. Before I start, I'd also like to thank my parents and my brother Matthew for listening to all my school stresses and my nerdy rambling about books and my favorite bands. Your wisdom, unconditional support, and let's face it, good genes are the reason I'm here. I'd also like to extend that thank you to all the families and parents of the graduates as well. Your encouragement and help does not go unnoticed. Folks, we made it. Congratulations to the class of 2021. I'm gonna be honest, I feel like we've made it through more than the typical graduating class. It's not often that high schoolers have to deal with a global health crisis on top of the stresses of a normal teenage life. Between school being suspended indefinitely in our junior year and being online most of our senior year, I think everyone should be proud of the academic and personal hurdles they've jumped over to get to the stadium. I think the big question at most graduations or any major pivot point in life is what's next? For 13 years, our paths at school have been highly structured. Our parents decided where we would live and what district we would go to. We spend most of our time at school or doing schoolwork. After graduating high school, it's the complete opposite. What we do and how we act is up to us. We choose if we want to work or join the military or continue our education. We choose where we live, what we study, and which career we pursue. After 13 years of structure, this much freedom of choice is pretty overwhelming. I'm sure I'm not the only one this happens to, but at every family gathering, I get questions about my plans for college. And I know I love books and music and learning, but I have no idea how that translates into plans for my future. So the question of what's next is always in the back of my head. If you ask me, I'm not qualified to give advice for the next stage of life at all. Good test scores do not always translate into broad understanding or life wisdom, and I'm just as confused as the rest of you are. Despite my fears about what's next, I do have confidence that our class in particular is equipped to handle the unknown. Nothing says what's next like waiting every 2 weeks at the end of junior year to see if we would be going back to school. Nothing says uncertainty like wondering whether we would have a prom, sports seasons, or spring concerts. I think it's safe to say that we're experts in dealing with change, doubt, and anxiety, which is a skill that will stick with us long past high school. Compared to the constant change we've faced these past 2 years, graduating seems a lot less frightening. And unlike changes due to COVID, graduation is a purely positive thing. We're here to celebrate our successes and look forward to new opportunities as we get older. We have the power to make a positive impact on our families, friends, and communities. Alongside the confusion and doubt, the question, what's next, should also produce excitement and optimism. As you walk across the stage, I hope you embrace the countless possibilities in the unknown with the confidence that you've made it through so much to get here. Thank you and congratulations again.
Congratulations, Grace. Truly amazing. Now for our second presenter, it is my pleasure to introduce my dear friend, Jaden Italiano.
Thank you, Belle. Good evening. It is my great privilege to introduce to you this year's valedictorian. I want to begin by letting you all get to know the Alex Bellissimo that I know. Alex Bellissimo is humble, disciplined, hardworking, driven, and bound to do something great with his life in the future. Alex is a two-sport athlete, a leader in both football and baseball. He is a role model for his sister Miranda, and all of his peers. He has a life of every party, whether it's tearing it up on the dance floor or making friends with someone he's never met. Alex Bellissimo was like a brother to me. I met Alex when I was just a year old. We were both forced to attend a playdate because our brothers Christian and Justin were already friends. Little did I know, that day playing Superman would lead to a lifelong brotherhood between Alex and I. We both went to the same preschool, was followed by 9 frustrating years of having no classes together, forcing us only to be able to hang out after school, having Nerf battles, or playing Legos for hours on end. As I said earlier, Alex and I never had a single class together at Jefferson Primary, Woodhull, or Findlay Middle School. It wasn't until high school that we began having classes together after 9 long years. Once we began having classes together, Alex went on to be the valedictorian. Now I'm not making any assumptions or anything, but it's kind of funny how that worked out, huh? But in all seriousness, I couldn't be more proud to call someone my best friend, and this honor couldn't have happened to a better person. At this time, please join me in a round of applause for your valedictorian and my best friend, Alex Plissimo.
Thanks, Jaden. That was amazing. I would like to start by thanking my family, Miranda, Christian, my mom, and my dad, for helping me get through every step of the way. I would also like to congratulate Grace, as I'm honored to receive and share this recognition with her. It's funny that we actually went to preschool together, and now here we are. I was once told that when you first start high school, the next 4 years will fly by. Standing here in front of everyone today, I know that, in fact, this is true. But despite this, I couldn't have asked for a better high school experience. We went from not being able to find our classes as freshmen, walking in late and being scared that we'd get into trouble, to knowing exactly where we were going, and well, still walking in late as seniors. Huntington has offered many opportunities for us to challenge ourselves, whether it was in the classroom, on the field, or on stage. Through these challenges, we have been given the chance to find our place and our passions. Although entering senior year in a global pandemic certainly wasn't ideal, there were so many positives that came out of it. We made the best of it, and I don't think I would have traded this year in for any other. The Huntington administration, teachers, and staff did a phenomenal job making this year feel as normal as possible for us. From going back to school every day, to being able to play sports and participate in extracurriculars, to bringing back field day and prom. Actually, they didn't make this year feel normal for us. They made it normal. For us to get through school and life in this way makes me excited for what's to come in the future for all of us. We learned how to be resilient when situations are less than ideal, which will help us to succeed. My dad's favorite quote was always, "It is what it is." I want everyone to think about this quote and what it means, as I think it can mean a lot to us as we move forward in our lives. Everyone has their failures, but it's what we do with our failures that will determine our success. I learn from every mistake, from every challenge that comes my way, and look for ways to make the future better while it's still in my control. There's no reason to worry about wrongdoings from the past, as the past cannot be changed. As I leave you all with these thoughts, I would like to end by saying that I've never met a more talented, fun, and hardworking group of people than the class of 2021. We've gone through so much together, and we've come out on top. I'm so glad to be a part of it, and I can't wait to see all of the great accomplishments that our futures hold. Thank you for the best 4 years, and good luck to all as we embark on a new journey.
Congratulations, Alex and Grace. How about another round of applause for them? They're truly amazing. Really quintessential role models for the rest of us. Up next is an outstanding person and neighbor of mine. She is the only person on stage that is actually shorter than me, so I felt like I had to brag about that. Miss Sarah Bernacki.
Hi, I'm Sarah Bernacki, and my mother is the president of the school board. Honestly, I should have played that card more often. It's too late now. I think the reason I never thought about doing that was because Christine knows how to keep those two roles separate. I know her as both the school board president, but also as my mom. Christine Bernacki has always been the one you could count on when you needed help. She was helping our district left and right and was always there to make sure things ran smoothly. And now, president of the school board, and my house, Christine Bernacki.
Thank you, Sarah. I'm so proud of you, and I'm glad you're sitting behind me, because if I think I was looking at you during this speech, I would definitely cry. It's Sarah's 18th birthday today, by the way, everybody. Woo! to the administration, teachers, my colleagues on the board, my colleagues as parents, and to the class of 2021. It is with such immense pride that I stand before this particular class of graduates. So many of you I've known since the first days you walked into your kindergarten rooms, a few even before that. When you entered the district in 2008, the world was in the throes of the most serious financial crisis since the Great Depression. And now you are graduating during a global pandemic. I don't think there has ever been a group of students that's more prepared to combat the obstacles that might be put in your path to your goals and dreams. Without question, you have gained the tools necessary to pursue your dreams and never let them go. In your 13 years of schooling, some of the issues you have faced were recessions, recoveries, superstorms, the influence of social media, and now the global pandemic. I have witnessed you respond with perseverance, compassion, and determination. It's been a privilege to watch. Think back to these past months during quarantine and restrictions and recognize the things that moved you, the people you relied on, and what gave you joy. Also, if there was something that you missed so much during this time, you now know it's something that you need to include in your life. These are the things on which to build your dreams and goals. It doesn't have to be the thing by which you earn your living. It can be a passionate hobby or a type of relationship that you need to have a successful life. Dreams can be defined as a wish or a fantasy, but also as an ambition or as a goal. I encourage you to combine these two definitions so that your goals will be filled with your passions. In other points in history, there have been times of suffering that resulted in rebirths and renaissance. Let this be that for you as an individual. Take what worked for you this past year and leave behind what did not. The Italian Renaissance created a cultural, artistic, economic, and political rebirth. I'm not saying that you have to invent the telescope or paint the Mona Lisa, but reach for the ceiling of your own Sistine Chapel because you know how to persevere in even the most challenging circumstances. You did it this year, and here you are graduating and moving on to your next goals. Let these goals be guided by your dreams and inspired by your passions. The great American poet Langston Hughes wrote during the Harlem Renaissance, "Hold fast to dreams, for if dreams die, life is a broken winged bird that cannot fly. Hold fast to dreams, for when dreams go, life is a barren field frozen with snow." Let your life fly by keeping those dreams alive. Congratulations again to the graduates and to your families. I'm so proud for my family to be counted among those celebrating today. I wish you all the sweetest dreams that will lead to the sweetest life.
Thank you for all you've done for us, Mrs. Bernacki, and the board. At this time, it is my honor to present the brightest light in our school, arguably. He always puts a smile on your face and always knows how to make me laugh, Mr. Jorge Cisneros.
Good evening, class of 2021, faculties and families. Buenas tardes, clases del 2021, profesores y familiares. My name is Jorge Cisneros, one of the members of the class of 2021. Today is a special day for our class that will live in our lives and hearts and future generations. Mi nombre es Jorge Cisneros y soy uno de los miembros de la clase del 2021. Ahora es un día muy especial para nuestra clase que va a vivir en nuestros corazones y generaciones a generaciones. From the beginning of the school year, our hopes were diminished as a result of the COVID-19 pandemic, but that didn't hold us back from succeeding. Desde el comienzo del año escolar, nuestros sueños fueron destruidos al resultado de la pandemia, pero eso no los detuvo a tener éxito. Being here is a privilege for everyone now, because we never thought we were going to have a graduation ceremony months ago before this beautiful evening. We all remain positive and hopeful of the future, especially one person in this district, which the class of 2021 is thankful for. Estar aquí es un privilegio para todos ahora, porque nunca creímos que íbamos a tener una graduación meses antes que esta hermosa tarde. Todos permanecimos positivos y esperanzosos del futuro, especialmente una persona que la clase de 2021 es muy agradecido con él. This person has contributed to our community since 2011. He came to the Huntington family from the South Huntington School District, where he worked as assistant superintendent for personnel and district service since August 2010. Esta persona ha contribuido a nuestra comunidad desde el año 2011. Él vino a la comunidad de Huntington desde el Distrito Sur de Huntington, donde él trabajó como un superintendente asistente desde agosto del 2010. He early served as principal of Walt Whitman High School for 6.5 years. A graduate of SUNY Albany, he earned a Master of Business Administration degree at Hofstra University and an Advanced Graduate Certificate in Education Administration at Stony Brook University. Tempranamente, sirvió como un principal en la secundaria de Walt Whitman por 6 años y medio. Graduado de la Universidad de Albany, él obtuvo su maestría en negocios administrativos en la Universidad de Hofstra y obtuvo un certificado en educación en administración en la Universidad de Stony Brook. One thing that amazes everyone about him is that he's always in every school event throughout the district, showing his support to all students, no matter what. Una cosa que sorprende a todos sobre él es que él siempre está en cada evento escolar en todo nuestro distrito demostrando el apoyo a todos los estudiantes, no importa qué. As an educator, he has made a positive difference in the lives of many students and families throughout his career. Nothing is more important to him than making connections with people. And just as he said, I quote, "I would not want to be anywhere else but with the Huntington family." Como un educador, ha hecho una diferencia positiva en la vida de muchos estudiantes y familias durante su carrera. Nada es más importante que hacer conexiones con personas. Y como él dice, yo cito, "Yo no quisiera estar en ningún lugar que no sea con la familia de Huntington." The class of 2021 is beyond grateful to have a superintendent like him, and we owe him so much for making our senior year something special to remember, no matter the challenges and that we faced this past year. La clase del 2021 es más que agradecida de tener un superintendente como él, y le debemos mucho por haberlos dado un año muy especial que vamos a recordar, no importa las circunstancias que pasamos este año. Es un privilegio para mí introducir a nuestro superintendente de las escuelas. The class of 2021 is honored to introduce the superintendent of our school district, el señor Mr. James Polanski.
Need a moment to gather myself. Good evening, and welcome to our students, trustees, faculty, staff, and guests. We have reached the end of a very long year, over 15 months, really. It's been a time of incomparable hardship and confusion, locally and well beyond. We have faced a global pandemic, social unrest, debates pitting public health against education, sensationalistic and sometimes undependable media reporting, and a blurring, actually no, sometimes a complete eradication of the lines between politics and just about everything else. Among the few constants during this period, the fortitude and determination demonstrated by members of Huntington High School's class of 2021. Please give them a hand. As I shared in my message to families yesterday, and I'm looking at them now, I wish I could keep you here indefinitely, but that would deny the rest of the world what you will bring to it. Your collective character and perennial optimism were consistent beacons of hope. Since last spring, there has been fear and loss experienced by many. This may very well have been the most difficult stretch that you have experienced in your young lifetimes. You have been reminded constantly of what you have missed. I implore you, however, to remember what you have accomplished, what you now know you can accomplish, your ability to bounce back even stronger as individuals and as members of society. You are resilient and do not shortchange what you have learned. You have gained a greater sense of the power of technology. In fact, it has likely changed the world of school and work as we know it. The way we have made and maintained digital connections since last spring are nothing short of extraordinary. Regardless, I hope you have also recognized the tremendous value in face-to-face connections. It is how society was built, and it can never be replaced. I hope you have learned to scrutinize what is portrayed in the media, particularly that of the social variety. Some of what you see and hear may be real, some of it may be slanted, some of it may be altogether untrue. You leave Huntington High School fully aware of the need to do your own research and to avoid taking anything at face value. And I hope you have also learned that feeding any frenzy on Facebook does not solve a problem, and the cloak of anonymity is not something to hide behind. You continue to model kindness and respect. You understand that small acts and first impressions can go a long way. And I'm going to give you an example that pertains to this class. This is personally one that I have never forgotten, and again, one directly connected to the folks here today. Early in my Huntington superintendency, and as Jorge mentioned, I've been here since 2011. I believe this group was in second grade at the time. I was making my way through one of our primary schools. I walked into a second grade classroom that had just completed a reading lesson. The students were making their own decorative bookmarks. Those in the classroom on that day could not wait to share their creations. I, of course, marveled at them like a proud parent. I'll not soon forget when one little munchkin came toward me, so pleased to have brought a smile to someone's face with her creativity, she insisted that I become the owner of her bookmark. Through the years, she has asked me on several occasions if I still have it. And guess what? I'm not going to make eye contact, so you're not going to know who this is, but I still do have it. And it is among my most prized Huntington possessions, as it helped me realize early on that I would make a home here. Further, it truly represents what our community has been all about. I won't embarrass her, but she should know, you should all know, all of our members of the class of 2021, what a difference you have made with your compassionate gestures, even those that may have seemed small or insignificant at the time. We live in a time when opinions seem to take center stage, and they are not all the same. And that's okay, because you recognize the power associated with true listening and empathy. You've never failed to see the value in what others have to offer, nor have you hesitated to place the needs of others before your own. As you move into the next stages of your lives, keep these words from Winston Churchill in your conscious thoughts. We make a living by what we get. We make a life by what we give. Take pride in your accomplishments during your years in Huntington. While you won't soon forget the uncertainty and apprehension that marred the past year, you should remain proud of your ability to adapt and to work through it. From being in school once or twice each week, to returning full-time, re-engaging in person, getting back to what you love, whether it be your participation in a club, mentoring your peers, providing a service to the community, performing in a drama or musical, or winning a county baseball championship. The spirit has returned. It has been said that there are several things you can't recover in life. A word after it has been said, an opportunity after it's missed, trust after it's lost, time after it's gone. With those things in mind, please, please never waste time arguing. Remain humble and kind, and embrace every moment you have with those you love. Know that we will always love you, and that Huntington will forever be your home. Good luck, and God bless.
Thank you so much, Mr. Polansky. Now that I'm graduating, I'm not going to lie, every time I hear you say good evening, I feel like a snow day announcement is going to follow. So I'm going to miss those calls. Up next is someone who truly is beautiful inside and out, and I'm going to miss my lunch buddy so much, Miss Angelica Hernandez.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Angelica Hernandez, and I would like to start by thanking Mr. Cusack for giving me the opportunity to introduce him today. Very often at this point, you'll start hearing about the biographical information, but I like to start talking to you about who Mr. Cusack is and what he means to us. Buenas tardes. Mi nombre es Angelica Hernandez, y primero le quiero dar gracias a Mr. Cusack por darme la oportunidad de presentarlo y hablar de él hoy. I'm not sure how many people are familiar with the rock that sits at the exit of the high school. Students are given the opportunity to promote activities or express creativity on our school's rock. And over time, it has built up with paint from different events and messages. When my mom was in high school, a long time ago, it was a tiny little rock. But over time, it has become something more meaningful to us. No sé cuántos conocen la roca que está al lado de la salida de la escuela. Los estudiantes tienen la oportunidad de pintarlo y promover actividades. Cuando estaba mi mamá en high school, era una roca pequeña, pero con el tiempo esto ha cambiado la visión de nuestra clase. On behalf of the class of 2021 and our school, I would like to say that Mr. Cusack has been that rock. Each year he has built us up from students to faculty. Mr. Cusack has been the core of the school. He has spent endless days and nights preparing to give us four amazing years of special memories and experiences. He has been an active listener to each and every student who has presented him ideas. En nombre de nuestra escuela y clase de 2021, le queremos decir a Mr. Cusack que él es nuestra roca. Cada año he crecido los estudiantes y a las facultades. Mr. Cusack es el centro de nuestra escuela y él ha tomado de su tiempo para preparar memorias especiales para los 4 años. Él escucha a cada estudiante que les tiene ideas para mejorar nuestra escuela. This past year, having to adapt new ways to keep the school year positive, he's been there for all of us. He was always looking for new ways to improve every student's time here at Huntington High School. The class of 2021 wants to thank Mr. Cusack for being an amazing principal who genuinely and deeply cares about every single student who walks in all the halls at Huntington. He has made my last 4 years personally something that I will never forget and will always carry on. Este año teniendo que adaptarse nuevas ideas para mantenerse positivo, él ha estado ahí. La clase de 2021 le quiere dar gracias a Mr. Cusack y es un principal que sinceramente quiere a cada uno de los estudiantes y a las facultades de la escuela de Huntington High School. Él ha hecho mis últimos 4 años algo que nunca voy a olvidar. Quiero felicitar la clase de 2021 y todo que hemos cumplido. I just want to congratulate the class of 2021 and on everyone's accomplishments. It is now my great honor to introduce our principal and our rock, Mr. Brendan Cusack.
All right, I'm crying now. Thank you so much, Angelica. Good evening, parents, guests, faculty, members of the Board of Education, Central Administration, and most important, the graduating class of 2021. Do you ever just stop for a moment, look around and say to yourself, well, how did I get here? Have you ever just kind of traced back the long and short-term events leading up to the very moment you are currently in and paused to just think about it for a moment? I am having that kind of moment right now. And maybe some of you are too. How on earth did we get here, in this place, all together, celebrating like this? It is no mystery that we all had many steps and quite a journey to get here. And you, our soon-to-be graduates, have certainly had many mountains to climb, many seas to cross to get to this moment. And now we can collectively pause, reflect on the path leading to the present, and breathe, knowing that we are really here. We are finally really here together, and it is a beautiful thing, and it is all for you. So So a question comes to mind. Yes, it's for you. We are all here for you. The question does come to mind, what is most important for us as we face challenges, big and small, like we have to get here, and as many of you have over time? What can be learned from all of this that we have experienced, and what might you take with you as you confront new situations and challenges along your next steps? I know it's very easy and quite cliche to say that there's always a silver lining in every situation, or to remember that in every challenge or disappointment there is a lesson. But I really am a true believer that no matter what happens, we must always find the good in everything, even in the difficult times, as hard as that may be. So I think there are many lessons that can be taken from the experiences of the last couple of years and beyond that will help in the years to come. But to me, the most important thing, the one thing that has helped me most, both personally and professionally, is to remember that no matter the situation, you always have the power to control what I refer to as the you inside of you. In order to illustrate this, I need to talk for a moment about turtles. I'm guessing there's a big picture of a turtle behind me, right? Cool. I think we all know how turtles behave. They duck inside their shells when they feel frightened or threatened, and they pop back out to eat, walk around, or get some sun. And there's nothing particularly instructive about that for us, really. They're turtles. I mean, what does that have to do with us or why we're here? The turtle, however, can be a source of inspiration for us, especially when facing challenges. Did you know that the average turtle shell can withstand thousands of pounds of pressure? But they don't start off that way, of course. It takes time for a turtle's shell to harden to the point where it can effectively protect a turtle. We are similar in many ways. People learn to protect themselves from both physical and emotional harm, but it takes time and experience. It takes practice and patience to know when to retreat into our shells and when to emerge, showing our true selves to others. The beauty of this, though, is not that we have the ability to emerge or retreat, to hide or come forth, but that we get to choose when and how to do so. We get to decide what we reveal and what we protect. And we get to be the ones who create our own environments inside our shells if we need to go there. With this understanding should come a sense of calm. To know that we can always be in control can be comforting to not only ourselves, but also to others. I'm not suggesting in any way that we should run and hide when things get difficult, but rather, when challenges arise, when storms rage around us, we should take comfort in the knowledge that we can always be safe inside ourselves. We are protected. We have the ability to retreat, regroup, recover, and reemerge ready to take on any situation. There is strength in this ability, and it can help others as well. When you have truly practiced the art of being in control during times of adversity and hardship, when you can really experience calm within the storm, others will sense this and be comforted as well. This is how we help one another, and this is what will make you a leader among others. So basically, as you're about to graduate high school and move on to new and exciting experiences, I'm asking you to be a bunch of turtles. I happen to think there's nothing cuter than a turtle basking in the sun, stretching outside of its shell, smiling up to the heavens on a little rock in the middle of a pond. Not everyone thinks so, perhaps, but no one can object to the idea that turtles are calm, wise, confident, and at peace. Blue Devils, as you go forth, be like the turtle, and may your every measured step take you inch by inch toward your goals, your happiness, and your sense of inner peace, so you may be a radiant leader for others to follow. Class of 2021, may you be truly blessed as you go forward. Never forget where you came from. Remember that we will always, always love you, and know that you will forever and always be Blue Devils. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Cusack. All of your hard work and dedication is really appreciated. As Taylor said before, our class advisors, Ms. Schessler and Mr. Jace, have done a whole lot and then some for our class. Personally, they became advisors inside and outside of school, always listening to us and being there for us. It is my honor to introduce Mrs. Schessler.
Taylor Case. Jaden Italiano. Gabriel Moskovich. Alexander Bellissimo. Grace Wildermuth. Isabella Algieri. Angelica Hernandez. Jorge Cisneros. Sarah Bernacki. Ariana. Layla DeVille. Ariana Guerrero. Brenda Acevedo. Olivia Adonis. Jennifer Aguilar. Lisette Alvarez. Naomi Amador Martinez. Alexa Amorison. Brianna Arias. Hallie Armengau. Aiden Bond. Torin Bograd. Alex Berg. Aiden Bender. Joshua Balin. Jonathan Alpalsinov. Sorry about that. Arnold Alfaro. Ryan Aguirre. Brendan Abedin. Michael Arwegua. Danielle Bright. Ava Brosnan. Mia Brown. Chloe Buffon. Yolani Cabrera. Johanna Campos. Erla Campos Nativi. Lainey Carney. Marilyn Castellan. Nyurka Chabla Leon. Sabrina Barreau. Emerson Flores. Matthew Colavecchio. Aaron Chin. Arliss Castro. Leo Castillo. David Cañas Granados. Tony Callery. Makai Butts. Mason Brewster. Jesus Bonilla. Jocelyn Chavez. Jasmine Clark. Congratulations. Joanne Clairvoy. Adora Collet.
You did it. You did it.
Claire Connor. Jordan Cook.
Congratulations.
Samantha Cotto. Amy Cruz.
Did it.
Kaylee Dammers.
Congratulations.
Estefanie De Leon. Andrea Delcid Ayala. Andrew Florville. Nathaniel Deegan. Logan Deegan. Nicholas Denseglio. Trevor Cueto. Benton Cueto. Carlos Cruz Serrano. Daniel Cruz. Harrison Cosine. Thomas Combs. Kyle Collalori. Giovanna DeVoe. Madeline Diaz Portillo. Isabella De Benedetto. Nina Draculich. Marina Durand. Mackenzie Eccles. Catherine Eichenberger. Jessica Earhart. Isabella Familietti. Daniela Faison.
I said it second time. She didn't write it. I got nervous.
Damian Garcia Ibarra. Thomas Fucci. Elijah Fresnel. Ethan Franciscovich. Walter Flores. Joe Neal Feliciano Lopez. Alex Fashilla. Matthew Fallon. Jaden Erickson. Jackson Dunn. Declan Duffy. Nadeli Fernandez Gutierrez. Jamie Flores Andrade. Annalise Fleith. Jordan Fort. Juliana Freebling. Jalen Fuentes. Amanda Fuentes. Sarah Garaputo. Natalie Jerome Fiente. Jocelyn Gomez Hernandez. Kaylee Gomez. Liam Hassett. Robbie Harrington. Seamus Hannon. Nicholas Hamilton. Kyle Green. Zach Gordon. Alex Gonzalez. Brian Gomez. Yael Garcia Martinez. Jack Giamo. Michael Girardi. Lauren Gooding. Julia Gorecki. Isabel Grenier. Marin Grosso. Emma Guba. Elizabeth Heffernan. Autumn Herkimer. Kimberlyn Hernandez-Valiz. Melanie Hernandez. Rebecca Hoffman. Anthony Joseph. Isaiah James. Brandon Ireland. Cipriani Irajeta. Eric Eidler. Owen Hasselbeck. Noah Hobson. John Holly. James Hohenrath. Alvaro Hernandez Benitez. Aiden Heller. Jacqueline Carrion. Christina Hornstein. Jelani Idrissa. Brianna Esaza. Lily Joseph. Grace Kenny. Caroline Kilgore. Timory Kopol. Anna Kulikova. Sasha Kulikova. Vivian Lavertu. Jessica Lemus. Marcus Mertz. Mason Mertz. Ethan Lavangelo. Couldn't read it. Samuel Levin. Aiden LaFay. Jack Karathowski. John Krish. Ricardo Yandres. CJ Caveat. Sahil Kapoor. Jackson Kanzer. Dejanay Linton. Eileen Lopez. Flores Lopez. Jasmine Lugo. Ainsley Lumpy. Mackenzie Madison. Charlotte Maggio. Kayla Maldonado. Juliet Marinello. Angie Mata. Trevin Marr. Andrew McKenzie. Harrison McKenna. Ethan McGinnis. William McClellan. Giovanni McCain. Ethan Martinez. Carlos Martinez. Alex Martinez. David Mariquin. Luke Maffei. Lisa Martin. Catherine McCooey. Grace McKean. Imani Miller. Alexis Monti. Carolina Morera.
Congratulations. Well done.
Kylie Morera Rivas. Cassandra Mori.
Yes, girl. Did it.
Eliana Ng. Lily O'Hare. Isabella Orjuela. Shaquelle Plummer. Stephen Queen. Joseph Patron. Nathaniel Otto. Michael Olivier.
Well done, Mike. Well done.
Joseph O'Connell. Jeffrey Ochoa Alvarez. Oh, wow. Joseph Nicotra. George Morris. Kyle Morera. Gabriel Morales Flores. Jessica Ortiz Castro. Kayla Owen. Rahalia. Oh, what's her last name? Patterson, I think. Gemma Pellegrini. Stacy Pena Sosa. Malin Perez Garcia. Scarlett Potts. Gianna Proceda. Emily Ramirez Brevaro. Jacqueline Ramirez Soy. Jameer Salette. Alex Rodriguez. Giovanni Rubio. Chad Rowe. Richard Rongo Jr. Christian Romero Garcia. Joseph Rambaldi. Nathan Ribando. Samir Rathor. Jonathan Ramirez. Belter Quevedo Ramirez. Gracia Rankowitz. Catherine Rankowitz. Joanna Reyes Martinez. Ashley Reyes Morales. Alexa Rind. Rosa Rivera. Chelsea Rodriguez. Julie Rogel. Valerie Rogel. Lourdes Romero. Julia Sabatino. Christian Ronin Hernan. Ryan Sirio. Osiris Shepherd. Joseph Shea. Christopher Segretti. Andreas Safarian. Congratulations. Andy Saravia. Jonathan Saravia. Angel Santiago.
Congratulations.
Rasheem Sexton. Cameron Santa Maria. Katia Sanchez Fuentes. Ana Segovia. Sophia Severin. Kate Sheeran. Sarah Siegel. Ella Siepel. Rowan Simpson. Caitlin Smith. Natalie St. Hours. Tess Stanley. Riley Zink. Selvin Velasquez. Harold Valencia. Jorge Valles. Miles Tierney. Baris Toprak. Joseph Chopiano. Nicholas Tedisco. Jairo Uloa. Devlin Starr. Brian Thomas.
It's good to see you. Thank you.
Andrew Spina II. Alicia Sanzer. Julia Steinberg. Gabrielle Trimboli. Karen Uloa. Jocelyn Valerio Rendon. Emma Vaughn. Ivania Velasquez Rodriguez. Adamares Ventura Sanchez. Alana Wallace. Fantasia Ward. Mary Warren.
Well done, Ms. Ward.
Chloe Wheeler. Wilmon Guevara. Kevin Chavez. Bleeden Martinez. Robin Zeng. Nasir Youngblood. Brian Wong. Moises Viatoro. Vincent James Velarde.
Okay, it's not over yet. Traditionally, the moving of the tassel at graduation is called turning the tassel. It symbolizes one's transition from candidate to graduate. Standard protocol dictates that the tassel be worn on the right side of one's mortarboard, that's the hat, at commencement, and then move to the left side upon being proclaimed graduates. Don't do it yet. Mrs. Bernacki, to you as President of the Board of Education, to Mr. Palacios as Vice President, to Mrs. Donovan, Mr. Dwyer, Mrs. Castera, and Mrs. Deanna as trustees of the Board of Education and toward the authority vested in you by the State of New York, I do hereby affirm and certify that those assembled here have qualified for and are worthy of receiving a Huntington High School diploma and with it the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Students, move your tassels from right to left. Ladies and gentlemen, may we present the esteemed Huntington High School class of 2021.